There's a very interesting connection between obstructive sleep apnea and depression. And I remember a few years ago, somebody coming into me, it was a woman in her mid-30s, and she looked a little bit washed out. And I asked her, has anybody ever asked you about the quality of your sleep? Now, for decades, she was suffering from depression, and nobody asked her about the quality of her sleep. In the literature, you will find countless studies showing the link between obstructive sleep apnea and how it causes depression. And what's more, if you are somebody with depression, and if obstructive sleep apnea is contributing to that, if you don't get your obstructive sleep apnea treated, well then your depression is not likely to be helped so much. So it's very important to consider the bi-directional relationship between the mind, sleep, and breathing. And about 20% of the obstructive sleep apnea have depression, and about 20% of the depressed population have obstructive sleep apnea. So the connection is quite strong there, and that connection needs to be investigated. The next time you go to your psychotherapist, your psychologist, your psychiatrist, your medical doctor, ask them, could you by chance have a sleep disorder? And could the sleep disorder breathing be feeding into your depression? And I would go as far as saying, we will never have tranquility of the mind and a gap between thoughts and feeling the energy and where we need to feel to be productive and also to enjoy life if we have obstructive sleep apnea, because obstructive sleep apnea, it affects our energy levels, it affects our mood, and it affects our cognitive ability. It's the elephant in the room when it comes to mental health disorders.